Self-assembly is an interesting word and refers to a type of process that occurs in nature, in industrial practice, in the laboratory, almost everywhere that one looks. Liquid water occurs because the water molecules interact with one another. That's a form of self-assembly. The self-assembly that we practice is such that the molecules that we use, we and others in this area use, interact typically with something else, and what we use typically has been a thin gold film, which is easily formed by evaporation of gold on a flat surface. So it's flat and it's reactive. Gold is surprisingly reactive when it's clean, and it's very reactive to sulfur-containing groups that are present on the self-assembled molecule. So when one has a flat surface of gold, and you bring down in this a solution that contains molecules that have a sulfur on one end, and other molecules as well, or other molecular groups, but sulfur in particular, that group tends to stick. And they stick in such a fashion that they bump up against one another. They form a dense monolayer. And that dense monolayer forms a structure of its own. It's effectively a two-dimensional crystal or liquid crystal. And these are remarkably, remarkably useful as models for surfaces of crystals, the surfaces of cells, entities that go into microelectronic devices. They have been used for a wide variety of applications simply because there's no chemistry that's involved in making them work other than knowing what types of molecules you can function. What this field has done is to develop the art of making structures that range from very small ones to very large ones, depending upon the structures that are involved and the way of putting them together, but doing so in such a fashion that you make one component and you make the other component, but then you mix them and everything that happens after that happens spontaneously. There are a very wide variety of ways of doing that, so it's quite a flexible technology.